Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom Shop here. Okay, I made a little bit of a purchase for myself recently, which is these, which are Hurricane's version of Crimson Trace laser grips that are usually fitted to Kimber pistols. They're very, very good. In fact, they're very, very good. They're pretty much identical copies to the real steel Crimson Trace grips. They even come with laser grips written on the base, which the Crimson Trace ones do have on them. The grip itself is plastic, as you can hear. So if you have got weighted grips on a plastic pistol and you take those off and put these on, it is essentially going to make your pistol a hell of a lot lighter. So be aware of that. I think originally Hurricane made these for the Covert 2. In fact, I know they did. It comes as part of their metal kit that they fit to the MEU. So of course it didn't matter because the kit itself is full metal or alloy, so it weighs quite a bit. But when you fit it to a plastic pistol, yeah, the weight goes right out the window. So be aware of that. I purchased the faux wood ones. They're not bad. They're not brilliant, but they're not bad. They don't exactly look that much like wood, but they're pretty good. They're not bad for what they are. And not only that, you've got the option, if you want to, of respraying them black. Although, if you do that, make sure that you block up the laser sight hole with a bit of blue tack or something so that you can spray it without any fear of paint blocking up the laser. Now, I must sort of bring in here a safety point as well. My two airsoft sites that I help run, we don't allow lasers of any kind to be used, mainly because of eye damage. You get certain real steel lasers and whatever, they're designed to go over several hundred yards. They're powerful lasers. You get that in your eye, you could be blinded. So be aware of that. If you're going to fit these on it, I'm not sure the power rating of this laser in here, but it's not that nice if you get it beamed in your eye, especially at night, or if you're using goggles, whatever, night vision goggles, whatever, it's not going to be that nice. So be aware of that. Alright, so think on the safety side. If you're a transitional user, i.e. for real steel training, but using airsoft as a cheap option, then they're perfect for you because they're identical copies to the real steel and they're good for target practice and so forth. With regards to practice, target shooting or whatever, the grips come with a tiny little Allen key, which is there, hopefully you can see that. See that little Allen key? That one there. Now on the top of the grip, on the right hand side, you've got a little Allen key bolt there and a little Allen key bolt on the side. Now that is for your elevation adjustment is on the top for up and down, and windage for left and right is on the side. The top one is very, very good. It seemed quite able to angle the laser up and down. So the trick is put the batteries in once you've fitted it, then level it up to the front sight. As soon as the red dot disappears behind the right front sight, then you, or is just above it, then you know you're on target. For the windage one, I was a little bit disappointed. Didn't exactly, it moved it in, i.e. from the right to the left, but it didn't go all the way. By the time it was all the way out practically, that little bolt, it wasn't anywhere near to where that front sight is. Well, it is, but it's about a millimetre to the right. So a little bit disappointed by that. If I take that bolt out any further, it will just fall out. You could thread lock it, I suppose, or super glue it in if you want. But, yeah, a little bit disappointed. But, I mean, I'm not worried because I just bought these as a bit of a gimmick, really. Although, for target shooting, I should imagine, yeah, if you can overcome that problem, then they should be pretty good. So yeah, it's just me being picky, I suppose, but yeah, so be aware of that. As you can see, I fitted it to my Kimber TLE2 Custom. This has got a metal slide on it, so it's still quite weighty, so I'm not too worried. And once the magazine's in it, it'll still add a bit of weight. But again, remember, as I said previously, if you're going to fit it to a plastic or all plastic MEU, then it's going to make it very light indeed. Now, these grips are advertised to be fitted to the MEU, i.e. the instructions that come with them, which I've got to admit are some of the best instruction sheets printed I've seen from a Japanese or Taiwanese or Chinese, whatever. company out there, aftermarket company. They are very, very good indeed. They're all in English. They are very well written. They're descriptive. The graphics are excellent. You cannot go wrong. If you do, then you're a numpty, and you obviously have definitely not got an idea of how to read instructions. Even how to put the battery in. Very, very important and a critical point, and is very, very good. So yeah, really, really good grips. Love them. Excellent. So 10 out of 10 for Hurricane for these instructions. So really, really good. With regards to parts that come with the grips themselves, you get 2 3-volt flat, pad type batteries. I don't know what the number is. It does say on there, but so you get those batteries, which is good. 9 times out of 10, with a lot of this aftermarket stuff, it comes with no bloody batteries, so it's very, very good. You also get 2 pins, which I'll explain in a minute, plus obviously the grips themselves and the Allen key. So yeah, that's all what you get inside. Now, in regards to the grips fitting them, there is a small slot, which hopefully you can see there. There's a slot in the back of the grip there. Yeah, I'm just poking the screwdriver into it. If you've got a 5.1 style ambi safety fitted to your gun, i.e. one with a bar on, which is like that one there, as you can see. See, it's got that bar on the end there, that little bar. That will slot into that groove on the underside of the grip there, so it will slot into that. So it's handy if you've got a 5.1 style ambi thumb safety, it will fit under that little groove. So handy little point there. So these will be able to fit to an ambi safety gun. However, if you've got an MEU, the ambi safety won't work, because it's the captured pin head version, with that hammer pin having a raised head on it, so that the other side of the ambi safety, which is there with a little groove in, hopefully you can see that on there, see that little groove that goes down in there, that's one side. This is, by the way, is off of an MEU. This is the ambi safety from it, so that will be sticking out and it will get in the way and it just don't work. So they give you the option, because the thumb safety will get in the way of the laser, so you can't have those fitted. So what they do is they give you the option by giving you a single safety hammer pin, which has got the raised end on it, i.e. the rounded end, as you would get with a standard 1911A1 or a Series 70, so you get that. You also get, which I think is damn good, is a cut-off rounded end, which turns your ambi safety from your MEU into a single safety. So you essentially fit the one side of your ambi safety. The other side, you push in this little plug, goes across like that, has a rounded end to it, and turns your ambi safety into a single. Really, really good idea. It won't fall out because it's got a rubber washer on it. The same for the hammer pin. That one's got a rubber washer on it as well, so that's not going to fall out. Really, really handy little thing to have. Excellent idea by Hurricane, and I can't congratulate them enough in that respect. They've done an excellent job on that. Really, really good. So, luckily enough, as I say, with my TLE2, it had a single safety fitted anyway, so I didn't have to worry about that. But if you have got the MEU and you've got that problem, you're going to have to, obviously, swap over the ambi safety into a single. Or fit a slot-type safety, which, actually saying that, I don't know how that's going to work, because, no, actually, that won't work. So I don't know why they've put that groove in there. Yeah, that's strange there. No, scrap what I said about the 5.1 safety. It won't work because it's still going to hit that laser mounting on there. So I don't know why they've put that little sort of gap in there. It doesn't make sense, that. But anyway, so there you go. Oh, well, you're learning things all the time here. But anyway, so that's that. So that's not going to work. So you're going to have to swap over, if you've got an ambi safety fitted of whatever type, you're going to have to swap out the hammer pin, and you're going to have to turn your ambi safety into a single by using that that little plug. So there you go. So, really good grips. Like the design. They're, as I say, lightweight. The electronics are very good. I'll show you. You've got a master switch, which is on the base here. which the real steel ones have got. So it's up, it's quite stiff actually, but it's up for on. Then on the front here, this section here, is your pressle switch, which turns the laser on and off. What I mean by that is, if I show you now, there we go, there's the laser. Alright, so that's the pressle switch. So when your finger goes on that, the laser comes on, as you can see. Alright, so yeah, so as soon as you press that pressle switch, it comes on, otherwise it stays off. Now, which is pretty good, because your other main finger there rests on that all the time. So as soon as you grip your grip or whatever, and before you pull the trigger, that laser comes on, as you can see there, hopefully. Does that show up on there? Maybe not. I don't think it is, but anyway, it is on, I assure you. It is on. Yeah, you can just about make it out there. There we go. So there you go, the laser is on. That's because I've got the proper grip on the pistol. So it works very, very well indeed. But what I would suggest is, if when you come to put your pistol away, I know it's sometimes hard to remember these things, but always put the master switch off, so that when you press that, the laser isn't going to come on inadvertently whilst in your bag. There you go, see, it's not going to come on. Alright, so there you go, that's the grips fitted to my TLE2. It will fit to any of the standard TM1911 single stack pistols, even to the Foliage Warrior, the Desert Warrior, the Night Warrior, obviously the MEU. It can be fitted to the Series 70 and to the 1911A1, but you essentially don't have to bother about the additional hammer pin or single safety pin blocking thing on the other side. You don't have to worry about them, because both the 1911A1 and, as you can see, the Series 70 comes with a single thumb safety, so you don't have to worry about that. So there you are. So that's the grips. They are very, very good indeed. Bit of a gimmick, because as I say, we don't allow lasers to be run at our two sites, purely for health reasons. You've only got one set of eyes, look after them. You're already firing plastic BBs at one another. If you're not wearing a full face mask and you've just got goggles on, then you're already taking a risk. So we don't want to add to that by having lasers flashed around all over the place. But for transitional real steel users who are using the cheaper airsoft pistols that look identical to the real steel as training aids, then yeah, these grips are very, very good indeed. For target shooters, they're really, really good, well worth investing in. So that's it. So as I say, Hurricane have done themselves proud on this. The instructions are exceptionally good. And they're fairly cheap as well, they're not too expensive. I think they're around about £30, I think. That's how much I pay for them from Elite Shooting Centre here in the UK. But again, they are sold by numerous other airsoft suppliers and retailers, so shop around if you're abroad, elsewhere in the world or whatever, and trying to buy them from Britain might be a bit expensive for you, so obviously, you know, go elsewhere or whatever. But if you're in the UK, Elite Shooting Centre is about the best place to go. Okay, they do, oh yes, before I go, they do them in different colours. I don't know if I mentioned this at the start of the video, but they do them in different colours. I've gone for the fake wood ones. Yeah, they're okay, but they do ACU, Digicam, whatever. They also do them in black, so, but it's up to you. I went for the fake wood ones because if they were rubbish or not that good, I could always have the option of spraying them black afterwards. But to be quite honest, they're not bad. I'm going to leave them as they are, I think. They make the pistol look quite nice. I always like wood effect grips on pistols. They always make them look a bit better. Anyway, so there you go. So that's my review of Hurricane's exceptionally good laser, or copies of the Crimson Trace laser grips. And hopefully you've enjoyed the video. They're easy to fit. They're just straight fit straight onto your pistol, so you don't have to worry about that. Try not to over tighten up your screws, your grip screws, but other than that, there's no real problems in fitting. Okay, so that's LaZouche Custom Shop saying thanks for watching, and remember guys, stay sharp but stay safe.